Hitomi, we just had an introduction, so we're not going to introduce each other. But my name is Hitomi, and today is a Kimono Kids Care Specialist at Fumiko Horan, and the model is Anissa Maston. So we are going to start the Kimono Kitsuke by Fumiko. And then while she's doing that, I would like to talk about kimono and the structure and the history while we are doing this. Okay, so you can start the kimono kitsuke. Kimono, maybe we can show the structure first. This is the kimono shape. Maybe we can turn around. Shape itself is like a straight cross, just sewing together, but cleverly done, I think. And this type of shape has been like more than 650 years ago, we have established this type of shape. And it depends on the trend and the fashion. There is a little difference across the timing, but this is how it has been, and this is going to be the way we use today as well. Okay, thank you, Fumiko. So while Fumiko is doing her beautiful work, I would like to talk a little bit about kimono on the side. So as I just mentioned, the kimono has a long history. It's more than 1,000 years that we have a kimono. And back then, 1,000 years ago, there was a more like a buchikake. You would perhaps see it after this show. With a fashion show, we introduced some Japanese wedding style as well. And then at that time, you see the longer train and then kimono, but this nowadays, we cut kimono like this, and that's how we are going to do. This type of kimono is firmly established during Edo period, which is a little more than 300 years ago. And then back then, we had a long train type of kimono. We didn't put kimono just like this yet now. And also, in the older time, we didn't have this type of obi neither. We had just a short, more like a tie-up, more functional type of tie-up stuff around kimono. And then kimono was also just on the length of our height. But now, as we can see, we have to do things like ohashori, which is the one that we are now, Fumiko is now adjusting. Kimono is made a little longer than our height. When we show the kimono in the exhibit, people often ask me, we thought Japanese people are really short, but actually kimono is quite long. And it's because in the old days, kimono was worn in a longer way, touching on the ground, almost like a dress. But nowadays, we don't do that way because that would hinder the movement. And then towards the end of the Edo period, we started to wear kimono like this way. So we tie up the kimono first around the waistline, and then there's a little more leftover length of kimono that would become ohashori. And then, so there's a little historical difference. And then I just talked about the little obi as well. This type of obi, very wide and more design, is also made during the Edo period. And that's the time the Japanese culture most flourished in enriched, just because we closed the country from outer world for close to 300 years, and Japanese people could establish very authentic Japanese culture. And a kimono reflects that type of all the elements in there. And then obi was also made this wider type. And it started from the kabuki actor that it looked quite elegant and appealing. So the normal people, I mean, commoners also started to take in that type of design. And then there are quite a few different type of tying obi. And then today, I believe, we'll have a little different type of obi than the way I do today. But Edo era, it's like a very social, socially divided time, like a class-oriented time. So it depends on the class. The code was strictly defined, and in the high aristocrat people could wear certain type of kimono and certain type of obi, certain type of hairdo, and certain type of makeup. So every details of the fashion even was decided by the code, and then we all followed by that rule. And then the one we do is more like a modern type of kitsuke today, but this is more like a young girl's kimono. And then while going before the Obi's explanation, I should also mention about the kimono reflects so much about nature. So we have regular springtime kimono texture and design, and also some of the kimono is like a layered, and then some are singular, and then some material really breathy if it's for summer. And then the pattern and the color also reflects what the time that you wear kimono and where you're going, who you meet. So all these are very in detail and then intricately classified. So now that the Obi is now going into around the models, and I think Fumiko is going to show the baby. Would you like to turn around here? So we'll turn around the model. And I believe they are going to do kazari bunko. Bunko musubi is one of those popular way of tying obi for the samurai class wives and the daughter. And then that back then, in the Edo time, the obi was not always tied on the back like this, sometimes in the front. And if you think about the functionality and the everyday wearing kimono, if you wear kimono every day, all day long, then that's how you have to do everything. You cannot put kimono so tightly. You would wear it more in a loose way, more comfortable way. And it makes sense that if you tie obi in the front, I think it's much quicker, you can do it by yourself. And the bunko musubi is one of those, it's hard to do by yourself, it's on the back. You have to do on the front, either front, or like Fumiko-san's doing right now, somebody else would put the kimono on. And then this obi is possible to have it on. But if you do it by yourself on the back, it's almost impossible. So when you have, if you are, belong to the class, like you have a servant or so, then the tie up obi could have more variation, and you can also make it more decorative. But if you're just doing on a more regular basis, and it's a different type of obi, it makes more sense. And then, so there's a variety of obi, and it makes it quite nice like this too. And then I just talked about a little bit of the seasonal difference and also classification difference. Kimono has so many different variety of codes, and today, for the code of kimono to be really fashionable, I perhaps missed a little bit, because this has the flower cherry blossom pattern on top of my kimono, obi, and then this would be really nice if it's just a little bit before the cherry blossom season. Once the cherry blossom's already gone, it's kind of rather tacky to wear things like this. So. But pardon me, I was expecting that the cherry blossom here still in a halfway bloom or so, but when I came here, oh, maybe I missed it, but oh well. So that now she's doing this obi, and obishime, obiage would be on top of this as well. And then obishime and obiage is also, in the kimono history, it's rather new. It's also towards the obiage. It's going to be put on the kimono. And then these are also rather new in the kimono history. In the old days, that was just the obi. It's used more functionally. And then when obi became wider and more decorative, and they also wanted to put all these to do different type of fasten obi, tying obi like she's doing, it's almost a necessary item to have obi shime and obi are. And then that's how we do, and then that's also became one of the item for the nice fashion statement. So it depends how you, what type of color you put, you can totally change the impression of kimono as well. And this is obi shime. And then she's using obi shime for finishing up this shape of the obi.
Would you like to turn around again?
And then she's going to finish up in the front. And so I mentioned for you over the Edo period quite much, but that's the time that the kimono culture and the Japanese culture also was most nicely developed. And then kimonos, all these items and nice decorative and designs are all perhaps created during that time as well. And then kimono, by seeing kimono, we can see, you know, situational and occasional, and then what type of social class you belong to. And those codes are more strict before the World War II. But after World War II, many people started to wear regular Western clothes. So kimono culture started to kind of diminish and then close to dying out, unfortunately, these days. But now hoping that I will bring the comeback of kimono, because kimono is very ecological. That even if you put 30 pounds or 40 pounds extra weight, you can wear same kimono. Even if you're pregnant, you can still wear same kimono. That's not going to happen in the regular clothing. Oh, she's now finalizing the obi again. As you can see, just adding these green color on top of all these kimono and the obi coordination, the impression changes quite much. And if you can imagine changing this color, you could also change the impression. Then that's how conveniently made the kimonos are, and also fashion-wise has nice aesthetical element, I believe. And this one has, here's a little bit of ohashori, we can see. And then because we started to wear this is to make ourselves more movable. And then if you have a long kimono like Edo's time or period, then it's not really easy to walk. So we changed this style, and this is how we are these days. And now she's showing on the back. And then I guess there's still, we can play around a lot from here as well, but I don't know how Fumiko-san would do from here, but this is a nice way of obi belt done for the young girl, and it looks really nice. Nice formal style of kimono. And then how long did we take? We only took like 10 minutes to do obi. And then so many people say kimono takes a long time, but it's a short while. You think kimono is long. Thank you very much for being with us, and I hope you enjoyed our show.